What's up guys, this is Chris here, and today we're gonna be doing another first shots. Today we're gonna be looking at the Colt King Cobra. Now the Colt King Cobra is one of the better carry revolvers in my personal opinion, at least from what I hear. I've actually shot one of these a few times, but I've never owned one. This is the first one I've ever purchased. This was re-released, I believe, in 2019 with a couple of different features on it that it didn't have before that I don't know currently. I do know what this model has. This model came with a Hogue rubberized grip, a double single action trigger, which is very nice. Obviously Colt's standard cylinder lockup and all that. It came with a gold bead sight with a rear truss sight, which is pretty cool. And it came with a 3-inch barrel. Now this gun is capable of shooting 357 Magnum or 38 Special. Today I think we're just gonna use 38 Special through it, maybe a few 357 Magnum in a little bit. One thing I like about the gun is how ergonomic it is and how big the grip is for a smaller revolver. I'm a big fan of that. I saw this at my local Shields and picked this up for I think $800, which I think is a pretty good deal for like a brushed stainless steel Colt, which generally comes in at a higher price, like the Python or the Anaconda, which I also have. I'm a big fan of Colt revolvers. They have great triggers and they have good quality overall. Now this one here is again meant more for carry, unlike the Python. You can get a 3-inch version of the Python, but it's still a larger frame than this. This actually kind of fits nicely in a carry holster. I often use this on the range and just kind of carry it in my pocket, to be honest with you. It has a 6-shot cylinder, which is more than enough for self-defense in my opinion, even for today's standards, especially if you get rounds on target. And obviously revolver is going to be more reliable in entanglements. I actually got into an argument in the comment section the other day about self-defense situations, and the guy told me that you shouldn't worry about entanglements because in a shooting that will never happen. Generally if you're going to be robbed, they're going to be fairly close to you because they have to get something from you that they want from you, whether that be your body, your money, or your life. They generally get relatively close, and in that circumstance you can have some problems with entanglement. You can have some problems with slides getting stuck, especially if you've done combatives with firearms, which I'm lucky enough to. And revolvers, you don't need any standoff. You can press the muzzle right into them and pull the trigger and it's going to do what you want it to do. So there are a lot of advantages to revolvers. That's just one of them. The other thing is it takes 38 or 357, so in an ammo shortage usually those two are relatively available and you can use both on the same gun, which is super cool. This is again a higher quality revolver and we're gonna check this bad boy out. We're gonna go shoot 100 rounds through it. Before we do that though, I do wanna mention my Patreon supporters. Thank you guys very much. We did buy this at Shields with the patron dollars. I appreciate that. If you wanna support the channel, that's the best way to do it. Just go to the link in the description and sign up. Also in that description is a link to a local shelter in Ames, Iowa. It's the YSS, it could really use your help. So please donate to those kids. And finally, I do want to thank the sponsor of this video. Coincidentally, Shields. Thank you, Shields, for sponsoring my video. We actually purchased guns at Shields a long time before they ever were a sponsor of the channel, and I've been buying stuff at Shields since I was a little kid. They are the sporting goods store that I've always gone to because they've been very pro-Second Amendment and very pro-gun. I also happen to have a couple of friends that work in these Cedar Falls Shields. Thanks, Austin, Craig, Blake, and Grant. You guys are awesome, and if you're in the area and you want to pick up a firearm, go down there and ask those guys. Appreciate Shields for sponsoring the video. They're a Midwest company, so go out there and support them. Now, let's go shoot this bad boy. Now, another great thing about revolvers is they can be easier to use with arthritic hands because there is no magazine or slide to use. You just simply open the cylinder and you can thumb the rounds in, which is real nice. Another thing I like a lot about revolvers is because they are generally double single action, they are easier to use with gloved hands. That one went in a little hard, so I was just making sure it was a 38. I don't want to be shoving like 9mm or anything in there. That's why I was looking down at the round. But since the trigger guard's so big to accommodate the double action design, it actually works really well. It actually works really well with gloved hands. It wouldn't close there for a second here. So let's try this guy out. Double action at 75, first shot. Miss. 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 Well, not so good. Maybe I'm going low.
I don't even see where it's going. That was sick.
Okay, so far we are 0 for 6. Now, one of the things that I find relatively interesting is that the trigger in dry fire feels really good, but the double action right about here sort of feels like it hangs up just a little bit before it pulls, and it's kind of throwing me off a little bit. So we'll move a little closer and try again. There we go. We're about 40 yards here, 45. single action is real nice, as Colts generally are. Nice. So one of the other cool things about revolvers is that you do get the double action trigger pull, so it's kind of like a safety. Long trigger pull is nice, so you don't have negligent discharges. And if you do get the gun out and you have some time, let's say I spot a coyote or something running about 35 yards and he stops, looks at me, I will have time to fan the hammer back and take an accurate shot. So I do like that as well. Now, we do only have 4 rounds in here, but I did want to mention that if you're used to Smith revolvers or something like that, the cylinder on the Colt does turn the other direction. So if you're gonna be like dead man loading and stuff, you should know that. Let's try some double action here, about 30 yards. Yeah, we only had 4, I forgot. So far, so good.
So you couldn't hit it 75, so we figured we'd come back to 100.
Yeah, well, seems a little unrealistic, but I like a challenge. That's how I got you. All right.
That wasn't a challenge.
Let's throw it in single action here and just see what we can do at 100 yards. If we get 1, I'll be fucking happy. Give me 1.
Got her.
Did you hear how long it took to get there?
I was like, oh man, that's not good.
I thought we missed.
I think it's high.
Okay, try to go low.
I might be
I think wrong. I'm out now. Let's see how we do with some pocket carry.
Apparently not great.
Yeah, I sucked. I didn't have a good grip. It's hard to get it out of the pocket. At least I know if I'm gonna pocket carry this bitch, I gotta get a little closer. If you're shooting, I'm gonna be like, stop, hold on, I gotta get closer. Give me a minute here. Come on, guy. Using a revolver. What am I doing? I need to get that. One of the things that I am having a little trouble with is the
handle.
Notice the weird ergonomics of the grip there. I'm having a little bit of an issue not bringing the gun down enough, and I think I'm sailing them right over it. A lot of times with revolvers, you have an issue with the trigger pull.
So it was going high.
What?
So it was going high.
Yeah, it was. So a lot of double action triggers can kind of mess up your trigger pull because they're just heavier and longer, and that is usually causes the gun to go left. And I usually err a little bit on the side of the right, but in this case, we seem to be sailing them high. Man, I am sucking with this. Wow.
At least a real man can admit when it's user error. Okay.
Maybe I can shoot better with my left hand. I guess I can.
Was that 5 or 6?
That was 6.
I'm bad at counting.
Oh, now we're having lockup problems. Classic Colt. Let's try a little carry stuff. Now, one of the things I've noticed with this is I can't really shoot it super quick because that kind of that drag on the back end of the trigger, it seems like I have to stage the trigger a lot more than I normally do. I'm not the biggest revolver shooter, but I've been known to shoot a gun pretty well or two every once in a while. And usually when it comes down to shooting, you just have to find the right technique for the right gun. And a lot of times you just have to change your grip. Like when I close my grip on this gun, there's no space at all for my left hand. So when I put my hand in there, I'm kind of going like this, and I don't really have anything to press my left hand on in order to control the trigger. And a lot of times trigger control is about how good and how strong your left hand is, because you can slap the trigger all you want as long as your grip is really, really good. And on a semi-auto, when I start going really fast, I start slapping the trigger more, my grip can keep me steady. Whereas on this, not really. So I end up having to slow down a little bit and staging the trigger. Doesn't mean you can't get hits. It It just means apparently you're gonna get less hits. So, interesting. Now, one of the other things I did wanna mention is this has to be the least comfortable grip as far as revolvers I've ever had. This piece right here is just beating the snot out of the web of my hand, much more so than even larger guns. I actually have the 44 Magnum version of this, the Colt Anaconda, which you guys have seen on the channel later this month. And I would say this has more recoil. Those 357s we were just shooting there were just popping the hell out of my hand, I have to admit. Yeah, it's interesting. I wouldn't say it's my favorite revolver. It looks real cool. All right, first impressions of the King Cobra were, they were all right. We didn't have any reliability problems, but I did have a couple of lockup and timing issues. Actually, kind of the same problems I had with the Colt Python, so I wonder if it's just the system that they use. Once they start getting dirty, they have some real issues. Now, the trigger was not my personal favorite either, especially in double action, but sadly, in a self-defense situation, I'm probably using double action, so that's kind of what I judge a revolver on. Most revolver triggers in single action are good. Not every revolver double action trigger is good. And for the price that this is, considering it comes out like $300 more than this guy, I wanted to mention this guy a little bit, because this is currently in testing for $1,000 in review, and this is currently the gun I actually use to walk around the yard and check stuff out at night, and this is just my go-to pocket carry revolver. And as you can see here, the grip on the Ruger LCR is so much more comfortable for me personally because of the angle of it. The angle of it, it doesn't bump my wrist, and now this is only a 2-inch barrel as opposed to a 3, but even 357 Magnums in this guy feel a lot less recoil than this because of that bump. As you can see, it's just kind of weird, as you can see there, if you match them up, side to side, there seems to be just a lot of wasted mechanics in the Colt as far as like size. And not only that, but it makes it less ergonomic, less comfortable. And along with the trigger and the gold bead sight, I gotta say, I'm not sure this is my favorite gun. It's a cool looking gun, and I like the fact that I've got the smaller version of the Python or Anaconda because I kind of have the set. That being said, as far as usability, if you're looking for a carry revolver, I mean, I would probably go Ruger or Smith all day. I mean, you're looking at probably $200 or $300 less for this guy. I'd be more confident in the operation of this guy. This one's stupid reliable. The cylinder works all the time. It's lighter, smaller, and faster shooting with a better sight setup and probably a better trigger. So, yeah. As far as like a quick comparison, I'd probably go with this one. That being said, if you like the looks of this and it's your one gun, you could certainly get used to shooting this and shoot it very well. And as long as you kept it clean, I'm sure you would be absolutely fine as far as the reliability issues, because that only seems to happen on Colts when they get dirty. But that being said, if you're not a guy that wants to clean a lot, if you're not a guy that wants to make sacrifices, pay a little extra money for cool factor, maybe go with the Ruger. If you like this video, please like and subscribe. Please help out your local homeless shelters and remember to recycle. I'll check you later.
Danger, Zeppelin! Danger! What are you doing? Danger! 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 Danger, sit! Wow.